Hello. Well, today in Austin, actually, it's been raining for the last few days and it really feels kind of good. But you know how the rain is, it tends to give us a feeling of being a little bit depressed or kind of down under the weather. But that's okay because it can also stir times to become creative and think about different things or study or do things like that. Well, today I don't have any kind of a plan for showing you any body work because I'm having a difficult time finding somebody with an injury. So if you happen to live in the Austin area and you know somebody with a back injury or some head trauma or post-op or even ankles, elbows, whatever, and they would like to be on camera and so we can show some injury repair work, please just give them my contact or give me a call. Let me talk to them and I'll vet them and see if they'll be somebody that I can do on camera well. I would really appreciate it because I know it's so much easier and you probably enjoy it more when I'm actually working on an injury because then I can show you what happens when all of that stuff is out of alignment or whatever. But anyhow, enough said about that. I'm becoming really concerned about people's health in general. As to what's going on really globally, locally in some areas, and all this kind of thing. And I'm rather muzzled on the YouTube platform, so I'm going to talk a little cryptically about some things. You'll have to just figure out what I'm saying. There's been some pretty serious reports that have come out on people who have volunteered to take the experimental jab, and that is that there's things called spike proteins, which are contagious, and it's the symptoms coming up in the people who have not been jabbed are pretty serious. They're very serious symptoms. The investigation and the work in the labs are still being done to figure out exactly how this is transmitted. But it is something that is not, well, let me just put it this way. It's something that is very alarming to me. I do have to work on people in very close proximity. I was not afraid of the first initial thing that we were told to be scared of. This is something that does very much concern me because I don't want to get ill myself working on somebody who may have be a transmitter, and that is what they are. They're a transmitter. These things are experimental, and they are not what they are said they are, which is what starts with a V. They are not that at all. It's an experimental running program, and I do hope that many of you are doing your homework and looking into this stuff instead of living into the fear factor of being very fearful of things where you're not able to think very clearly about what you're doing or you're being peer pressured into things. I have a sense that some of the people that have been forced into this or threatened with their jobs, that those who have done the threatening about that are going to find themselves in some pretty serious hot water as time goes on, because the harm that's being done to people right now is very concerning to me. So now that we know that there's something out there that is truly threatening on the life and livelihood of humanity, what can we do about it? Well, number one, inform yourself. Please inform yourself. Take a look at many different things. Don't look at what you're hearing from any of the organizations that they say are the experts or the authorities, because they're really not. There's two timelines going on. There's two agendas going on. One is going to be for humanity, and the other one is so much, very much against humanity. So you're going to need to discern, and you're going to need to see what's happening, and then begin to find yourself. You know, I looked in the, I was, I pulled a book out the other day that I hadn't seen for a long time, and because I wanted to reread the Book of Thomas, which is not in the Bible, it didn't make it into the Bible, and there. He mentions that we are the poverty if we don't know who we are. If we don't know who we are poverty. We are the poverty. And now that I'm looking out there at the world and I'm seeing, all these things going on, and a lot of things people are doing to themselves without really understanding what they're doing to themselves is showing me that many people don't know who they are, and they are becoming the poverty, and they are actually separating their, a lot of their wholeness, they're separating a lot of parts of them out, disconnecting from who they are, because they haven't either found themselves or they just aren't bothered to look for who they are or discover who they are. So they're just following a herd, a suggestion, a command without much thought. That is the first thing you've got to do if you want to become a little bit more higher minded, is to check out what you're believing in and what you're doing and what your actions are. As far as treating anything like this, there's actually nothing that can be done except for build up your immune system to the highest possible level you can and stop the practice of causing harm to yourself. There's things that can be done to build the immunity up. That's something that many other doctors are out there talking about. I am not an expert in that, but I do pay attention to a lot of the doctors who are frontline doctors. I look at a lot of their research papers, and I do have a pretty good grip as to what is happening. Although, because I'm not an expert in that, I'll let you do your own homework in that and discover the people that have done their due diligence and who have been in the field for a while. So I guess I'll round this all up because I don't want to make it too long. And I just want to say that I care a lot about the health of humanity, and I care about what's happening to people's health. But right now, we're the wheat and the chaff is being separated. There are two timelines at play here. And it's not that we're going to be picked for one timeline or another. It's that we have free will and we have a choice to pick which direction we're going to go. So if you have questions about any of this, please try to find the answers to it. Think about what you're doing before you do it. Explore, examine, research out what you're doing, what these things are that they're asking you to do. What is it really doing to your health? And I'm telling you again, I know some people get really roused when I say this, but the covering over the face has not done anything but cause harm. There is, by statistics, what I have recently read, there's about 35% of the people who have been having to hide their faces on a hourly, many hours a day, are 35% of them are coming up with throat cancer. So there's something to all that. It's not as safe as what has been told. And it's time for humanity to get off their knees. It's time for humanity to start to realize what freedom is about. Freedom is about self-responsibility. Freedom is about communicating with other people, listening to what they have to say, and then pondering what it is that is being said, and check it with your own heart, with your own higher mind, with your own higher being, and learn to discern what the deception is and what the truth is. And we can change this world, because it's up to the human being to change it. It's not up to any governments. It's not up to anybody in power. It's up to you and me and other people. So if we're going to just follow the lead, follow what we're told, we're never going to grow, we're never going to learn, and we're going to end up finding ourselves very sick and very poor. We will be the poverty. So with that, I want to say, let's hope the sun shines soon. Hold on tight, because we're going through some rough water. Think for yourself, ask questions, and come through this as a shining bright light and a much stronger human on the other side of it. So with that, I say thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your likes. Thank you for your shares. And thank you for going to the page and looking at the products there, because a lot of things that are there are very helpful for your well-being. With that, I say goodbye and have a great day. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for subscribing. And I think there's a little bell up there that you can hit that you'll get a notification every time we post. So if you want to, you can hit that too. But thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it.